When it comes to Halloween decor, people in our area like to deck out their homes with all sorts of things like fake spider webs or huge outdoor inflatable characters.
Well, one man's home in Berwick has essentially become Halloween Central year-round after turning an old church into a not-so-typical home. News 16's Ryan Lucky and his Botox mask haunting that house this morning in Columbia County. Good morning. You know I love you. Come on.
What do you mean it's a mask? It's real.
It doesn't move.
It's true.
And there's nothing wrong with that. So this morning I am hanging out in this Columbia County community, Mindy and Tom. And what's really cool about this segment, we hope it's a whole mood on this Friday. It's bringing things together if you love home renovation or even Halloween. And I want you to meet Mikey Hanger, who took this amazing old church and turned it into, what do people in this neighborhood call it?
It's got many names. Halloween house, Gothic house, Black church, Mike's house, weird guy from TikTok's house, you know. You never know what they're going to call it.
Now, we really have to pull back the curtain and tell people about the history behind this historic church turned into a Gothic home. Tell me about it.
So it was built in 1906. I know that. It was a church for many years, and I believe some people tried to live in it for a couple years, and it was abandoned for about 10 years. And I always saw it as a kid, and I was always interested in it. And I've got lucky enough to purchase it and, you know, create something for the town, you know, give them something to believe in, you know, inspire kids to want to create and, you know, do something out of the ordinary and not worry about what people say.
What's the misconception you think of people have of this house when they see it? A lot of religious artifacts here, but you grew up Catholic.
Yeah, you know, I mean, from the outside, you see a black church, you got gargoyles, all that stuff out there. I do it, you know what I mean, because me personally, I feel like I don't like when people judge you from the outside. A lot of people have more to offer. So when you come inside, you see all the religious artifacts. Sometimes I think I have more stuff in here than the Vatican itself. But I love old religious things, and I've been collecting for years. And to me, it's art. And I'm a creative person, and it really helps me express that.
So interesting just to see what you've done with this place with a lot of black paint. By the way, speaking of other Halloween decor, a lot of you chimed in on a recent Facebook post that I put up and shared some amazing pictures. Wow, inflatables and all sorts of spooky getups. People are really creeping it real this Halloween across northeastern and central Pennsylvania. So we also appreciate you sharing what your front, backyard, and community looks like with me on Facebook. Hey, something interesting, by the way, when you look at this 115-year-old church, allegedly it's haunted. Now, Mikey shared an amazing photo with me that I want you to be the judge. Do you think this place is haunted? You can go to my Facebook page. I currently have the picture there as well as on my Instagram, and you could take a look. But you even said yourself, sometimes you get creeped out being here alone.
I can't walk outside without someone telling me it's haunted. I didn't buy it for 2 years because I was told it was haunted. And you know, whether you believe it or not, there is some weird things that happen here. I mean, there's a lot of energy here. It's built in 1906. A lot of people came and gone. So I've dealt with a couple things. I will say this, it does not like 80s music. I love 80s music, but every time I play it, you know, I always have an issue. So.
Interesting stuff. Yeah. More to come here from the Berwick area. And still ahead, while some of you might be having a coffee break this morning, guys, I'm going to be taking a coffin break ahead around 6:10 a.m.
Oh, I was going to ask you if it was haunted. I can't wait to hear more about that. Thanks, Ryan.
Thanks, Ryan. Let's check
out my Facebook page. It's on there.
I will.
Tom.